Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the Word of God. You're listening to The Moment of Power with Azano Eddie Thompson. Daily audio devotions to energize your day, presented by the Advent Hero Ministries.
Our Moment of Power topic today is titled, A Convenient Time. And as he reasoned of righteousness, temperance, and judgment to come, Felix trembled and answered, Go thy way for this time. When I have a convenient season, I will call for thee. Acts chapter 24, verse 25. Our scripture for reflection today tells of Paul reasoning with Governor Felix, who had desired to hear of the Christian faith. Although his wife, Drusilla, was a Jewess and had rejected the gospel, Felix still wanted to hear. Paul, who had been wrongly accused and was being persecuted, had to defend himself before earthly rulers. In the course of defending his faith, Paul was now speaking to the conscience of his audience, especially that of Felix. He was reasoning about topics that most preachers usually shy away from: righteousness, temperance, and judgment to come. Righteousness is right doing and following justice. Temperance is the total avoidance of that which is harmful or bad, like alcohol and cocaine, and the moderate use of that which is good. Judgment is the idea that we are responsible for all our thoughts, words, and actions, and we give account of them to God. Conviction started gripping the heart of the governor as Paul spoke. The Holy Spirit was striving with him to repent and to give his life to Christ, but as he considered not yielding to the wooing of the Holy Spirit, he became uncomfortable. The Bible tells us that he trembled and would hear no more the pleading of the Holy Spirit through the servant of God. He stopped Paul and told him he would want to hear him at a more convenient time. Unfortunately, that convenient time never came for him. There is never a more convenient time to repent than when the Holy Spirit is making strong impressions on your heart. Quote, instead of permitting his convictions to lead him to repentance, he sought to dismiss these unwelcomed reflections. The interview with Paul was cut short. A ray of light from heaven had been permitted to shine upon Felix. When Paul reasoned with him concerning righteousness, temperance, and judgment to come, this was heaven-sent opportunity to see and to forsake his sins. He had slighted his last offer of mercy. Never was he to receive another call from God, unquote. Ellen White, Acts of the Apostles, pages 4-6 and 4-7. Are you in danger of slighting God's last offer of salvation to you? Dear child of God, do not do so for any reason. No earthly gain or sinful pleasure is worth holding on to in the light of Calvary. If you look from self to the one who died to save you on Calvary, you will not procrastinate your repentance. It is the most dangerous thing to do. Accept the truth as it is in Jesus Christ today. Today is the day of salvation. Harden not your heart, says the Spirit. This is your hour of grace, of acceptance, and of salvation. This is the moment of power. May you not put off accepting all the truths of Christ made known to you today by providence In Jesus' name, amen.